stashes are good for local development, here's the situation in which you use stashes the most. Let's say that you have checked out the feature branch that you are working on. Then you want to either switch or work on a different branch. But you have a list of changes that you have not committed yet, but want to delay committing them for whatever reason. For instance, you're running into issues with your new code and don't want to commit bad code. Most of the time, Git will not let you switch branches if you have uncommitted changes. This is due to possible merge conflicts. A warning message will prevent you from switching the branch. You can stash the uncommitted changes, which means save a temporary snapshot of the uncommitted changes, then discard them so that you can change branches. Now you may switch branches because your uncommitted branches have been stashed away and are not currently present. The whole purpose of creating stashes is so that you can restore them at a future date. You can restore a stash by right-clicking on the stash you wish to restore. You can preview that stash by left-clicking on it. Click on Apply Stash. What has just happened is that your uncommitted changes have been restored and you once again have these uncommitted stages. It is important to note that when you restore a stash, you are not making a permanent commit. Stashes involve no commits, so they are not permanent. In order to commit the changes into the repository, you must follow the typical commit process after restoring the stash. You may then delete the stash if you wish. In summary, stashes are for saving, temporarily, uncommitted changes to your local machine. Stashes are not for committing to the repository, nor are they available for others.